In a huge win in the fight against climate change, a Montana state judge has ruled in favor of over a dozen young plaintiffs who argued that the state's fossil fuel projects actually ended up violating the state's constitution and its guarantee to a clean and healthful environment. So they look at the constitution, they see the actions of the fossil fuel companies, and these teenagers are like, we're gonna go ahead and sue. And so here's what happened. We're gonna tell you about the decision by the judge and what it potentially means. I think it's really important to get to know these teenagers first, starting with this wonderful woman, Sariel Sandoval. So she is one of the plaintiffs, and she says that the huckleberries that her family turns into syrups and jams are smaller and harder to find every year as a result of the impact of climate change. You also have Kean Tanner. Kean Tanner is an avid fly fisher, but over the years he's had several fishing trips canceled thanks to wildfires. He worries that the rising freshwater temperatures and droughts are killing off Montana's fish, and he has good reason for that. There is evidence to show that climate change leads to the warming water and has a negative impact on the marine life as a result of that. You also have Badge and Lander Bus. I just love how young they are and how aware they are of what's going on with our planet and with their state's constitution. So Badge and Lander Bus are avid hunters, but they fear that climate change is hollowing out the populations of the Montana wildlife. So I like that they attack this from both the financial impact it's having on their families, but also the impact it's having on their personal lives and their interest in nature and their activities, their hobbies. Now props to these kids because they're fighting not just for themselves, but they're fighting for everyone in the state of Montana. And if this expands into something bigger, which I hope it does, they're fighting for future generations to come. Now these teenagers were represented by an organization known as Our Children's Trust. It's a nonprofit that has taken up legal action on behalf of young people in all 50 states. I like their strategy here. As we mentioned earlier, the case in Montana hinged on a specific clause in the state's constitution. Montana's constitution includes rights to a clean and healthful environment for residents and future generations. The plaintiffs sought to force the state to drop a provision in the Montana Environmental Policy Act that barred officials from considering the consequences of climate change when permitting new energy projects, saying that it violated those constitutional rights. The case, which was argued in a Montana state court, was expected to be a battle over the reality of climate change. However, a little twisty twist here. In a surprising twist, the state of Montana began and ended its defense in just one day. They barely even fought this, which is fascinating, arguing that the legislature should be the one to make changes to the law as opposed to the judiciary. They also pointed out that even if Montana completely stopped using fossil fuels, it would have a minuscule effect on the global sum of carbon emissions. That's a fair point, but apparently not big enough of a point to persuade the judge to rule against the plaintiffs here. So Michael Gerard, the founder of Columbia's Sabin Center for Climate Change Law, said everyone expected them, meaning the state, to put on a more vigorous defense, and they may have concluded that the underlying science of climate change was so strong that they didn't want to contest it. And today, District Court Judge Kathy Seeley ruled that the contested provision to be constitutional, unconstitutional, I should say. Here's what will happen next. Thanks to this ruling, the decision today says that the state must either, one, have discretion to deny permits for fossil fuel activities when the activities would result in GHG emissions that cause unconstitutional degradation and depletion of Montana's environment and natural resources, or infringement of the constitutional rights of Montana's children and youth, or two, the permitting statutes themselves to be unconstitutional.
Yeah, okay, so look, I love this story. I love that young people brought it forward. I love how creative it was, and maybe the precedent that it sets. But okay, let's do notes of caution, and then I'll open up another possibility. So number one, it's definitely gonna get appealed. And I think that part of the reason that they didn't mount much of a defense is they're like, look, some court is like along the way, either this first court or the one after that or the one after that, or if it goes all the way to the Supreme Court, they're definitely gonna rule in our favor. Corporations own all these courts. They are packed with people who worked in, as corporate lawyers. They have groupthink. They're chosen by politicians who are all funded by fossil fuel interests. So they must have thought, this is a layup. We don't even have to present a case because the courts are already so corrupt. They would never allow us. Like what? It's unconstitutional for us to make money from our greed? No way, no way, right? So they got a rude awakening, at least in this first trial. Let's hope it continues on appeal, and let's hope they keep not presenting any defense. And of course, look, the science of it is 1000% settled. Putting on a science defense is absurd. They'd have to put in a bunch of quacks, you know, etc. And that's not gonna be persuasive. No, they have to put on a defense basically saying, I don't care, I just want the money, Lebowski, right? And yeah, at some point, some set of judges will go, oh yeah, of course, who cares about the planet? Who cares that it's in your constitution? Burn it to the ground as long as the politicians are making money from these donors. So that being said, Montana, and look, this is both good news and bad news. Montana's constitution is pretty clear about this. It's in the constitution. So the good news part of that is that they're just gonna have to flat out lie to loot for the state to win this case.
Right,
exactly. At some point, and some judges have to go, plain meaning of the words, nah. Did we say that as conservatives our whole lives? Nah, who cares, words don't have any meaning. Just make money, I don't care, make money, burn it, burn it. So will they? Probably, okay? So, but they're gonna have to ignore obvious plain reading of the Montana constitution, okay? Now the bad news out of that is that other state constitutions don't have that language.
Right.
Right, because they're talking about a clean and healthful environment, and it's guaranteed. So yet, and so, how do you know this particular law violated that? Well, one of the things that the plaintiffs put forward was in Montana, the number of fossil fuel companies that have been rejected for a permit is zero. They are never rejected, never. Burn it to the ground, take the money. Give us a small percentage for all the government crooks, the politicians, etc. And then let's just run and let Montana burn, let everything else burn, who cares? So that's what's happening in that regard, and other states maybe have denied a permit or two, right? But in Montana, they're brazen. The crooks that run Montana say, give them all, just take everything out. We don't give a goddamn about climate change. We don't give a goddamn about anything, okay? And then I have an idea for how to fight back related to this, but Anna.
So look, considering the fact that the state didn't really even try to defend themselves, I don't think that they're gonna appeal it. I could be wrong.
No, they're definitely gonna appeal.
But like, okay, how are they gonna defend, you know, the permitting of fossil fuel companies drilling and fracking and all of that? When that would literally require them to say that these activities are not harmful to the environment and do not go against the state's constitution. Like, I'm curious to see.
I think there's some chance they never present a defense in any of these trials. And it goes all the way up to wherever it goes. And some courts go, no, we don't care. We don't care, we're just making political decisions here.
Okay,
they're all activist judges.
Look, so we're speculating about the future of this. So who knows how it's gonna play out? We'll update you as we learn more. But my point in even bringing that up is to say, if this ruling stands, even if other states don't have this awesome provision like in their constitution, the good news is this sets a precedent, right? There is now record of the acceptance that climate change does not, fossil fuels are contributing to climate change and that does not lead to a clean, safe, healthful environment.
Yeah, no, no.
So that's the good news about
this. The precedent is great, and that's gonna lead to my idea here in a second. I'm sorry that I'm being bah humbug about it.
Yeah, but what's up with that?
Come on. I know, and thank you to the judge that ruled this way, the courts that ruled this way. Thank you to the people who brought it up. I would bet any amount of money that they lose at some point on appeal. The justice system in this country is way too crooked to let the people win. It almost never happens. You know how they always saying with climate change, thousand year storm, it's happening every year. The courts going all the way through and ruling on behalf of the people, that would be a 1,000-year decision. Like the first time in 1,000 years. Anyways, but look, here's one way we can win in the long run, partly based on this precedent. I think small businesses should do class action lawsuit against larger businesses, the fossil fuel businesses. This is against the state. Now, doing it against the fossil fuel companies is in some ways harder, right? But the reason why I say small businesses, because the average American doesn't count for anything in this country anymore. So if you're an average American and you sued, this is the reason we're flipping out over this, is because it's nearly unprecedented that an average person would win in America in the court system. But businesses win all the time. So you have to put business versus business for the courts to even pay attention 99 out of 100 times. So I think that it's opened up an interesting avenue to pursue here through the court system, even as corrupt as it is.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.